Good morning, children. So in the last class we had done till question number 5-1. Now let us see next. So before we go to question number 5-2, let us try to understand this, that if you have got two complex number, let's say z1 is a plus ib and z2 is c plus id, so in that case we'll say that these two are equal. Okay, only if A is equal to C and B is equal to D. I mean to say, real part of Z1 should be equal to real part of Z2 and imaginary part of Z1 should be equal to imaginary part of Z2. Okay, so now here question number 2, we have got this on the left and this is equal to A plus IB and we are looking for the value of A and B. And later, once we have found A and B, we have to find the modulus of A plus IB. Okay, so let us see this. So while solving this question, you don't have to do anything on the right, though you'll be copying this. You have to copy your right hand side in every step. So here on the left, whatever we have got, we have to simplify that. We have to simplify this in A plus IB form. Okay. So here this is what we have in the first bracket and this is in the second bracket. Okay, now we will multiply, so this minus 2 will multiply with this minus 3, you are getting 6. Then this minus 2 will multiply to this plus 2 into root minus 3, so you'll get this. Then plus root minus 3 will multiply to this minus 3, you will get this. Then again this will multiply to this 2 times. Okay, so you are getting 2 into this square. Now in the next step, this is simply 6. Here this, it is 4 into root minus 3. Here 3 into root minus 3. So you can simply add whatever we have in front. So minus 4 plus minus 3 will get minus 7 and then keep this here. Okay, and here square root of minus 3 whole square, so simply you get minus 3. And here in the next step, this square root of minus 3 can be written like this, and then you can write like this. So you know that this is equal to I, so simply put I. So here square root of minus 3 can be written as this. Here plus 2 into minus 3 you get minus 6, and then plus 6 and minus 6 you get 0. Okay, and here minus 7 root 3i. okay, since square root of minus 1 is I. Now you can compare both the side. Here this is the real part and here we have 0 as real part. Here b is the imaginary part. For imaginary we have minus 7 times root 3. So we got our a and b. Now let us suppose that z is equal to a plus ib, that means z will be this. Now modulus of z will be given by square root of a square plus b square. Using this formula we will get this. Okay, so we got the modulus. Now next is integral power of I. Let n be a positive integer. Okay, n is a positive integer. Now you should remember that I to the power 2n, okay, it will be either minus 1 or 1, okay, depending on n. So if n is odd, then you'll get minus 1, and if n is even, then you'll get 1. Okay, so you can see over here, this is I to the power 2 into 3. This is your n over here, which is odd. So your answer will be minus 1. Here we have I to the power 2 into 4. this is your n, which is even. So this will be equal to 1. Okay. So remember this, where n is positive. Okay. N is positive integer. Now let us see this question number 6. Here we have to simplify this. So we have I cube plus minus I to the whole power minus 3. So this I cube can be written as I squared into I. Here you can see in power we have negative, so I can write like this, minus I to the power 3. Since here this power is odd, okay, firstly I square means minus 1, minus 1, and here I, so simply minus I, and here power is odd, so we will get minus I cube minus I minus, and for I cube just now you saw that it's coming minus I, yes. So in place of I cube I can write minus I, so I get minus I plus 1 upon I, because minus into minus plus. Now you should not have this I in the denominator, so you need to multiply by I and divide by I, so you will get minus I plus 1 by I into I divided by I. So minus I, this 1 into I, you simply get I. Here down you are getting I square. Okay. So minus I plus I, and here minus I, here I square means minus 1. So we are getting I minus I, because here plus, here minus, sorry, minus sign over here. So minus I, you get minus 2i. Okay. So this question number 6 one is done. Now let us see next one. Here number 2. So here we have 1 plus I whole square, then in this bracket we have I plus 1 by I cube. So using A plus B whole square formula, 1 plus I whole square can be written as 1 plus I square plus 2i. Okay. 1 plus I whole square. So you get 1 square plus I square plus 2 times 1, and here I. Okay. So that's what we have got over here. But you know that I square is equal to minus 1. Yes. So in the next step, you can write 1 minus 1. These two will cancel, will become 0. Here 2i. And this I cube can be written as I square into I. But I square is how much? Minus 1. So that minus 1, and here I. So you are getting minus I. Okay. Done till here. Now you can multiply inside. Okay. So 2i into I, you will get 2i square minus, okay, 2i upon I. So ii cancelled, and here I square is minus 1. So 2 into minus 1 minus 2. So you are getting minus 4. Okay. And note this. Suppose we have a complex number z equal to a plus ib, then this complex number will be called purely real. Okay. It will be purely real if b is 0, and it will be called purely imaginary if a is 0. Okay. So please write down this in your copy. So here z is purely real if b is 0, and it's purely imaginary if a is 0. For example, here z1 is equal to 0 plus 4i. So here you can see your a is 0. Yes, so real part is 0, only imaginary is present. So this is purely imaginary. Here in the second one you can see that b is 0, that means imaginary part is 0. So this is purely real. Okay, this is your homework. For this you have to use a plus b whole cube formula, expand this, then simplify. Here use a minus whole cube formula, simplify. Here you use a plus b whole square formula, simplify. Here a minus b whole square formula, simplify. Okay, your a plus b whole square formula is a square plus 2ab plus b square. A minus b whole square is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Your a plus b cube is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab a plus b. Okay, a minus b cube is a cube minus b cube minus 3ab a minus b. These are the formulae. Now let us see question number 7. If z is equal to x plus iy and mod 2z minus 1 is equal to mod z plus 1, then show that x square plus y square is equal to 2x. Okay, so z is equal to x plus iy is given to us, plus this relation is also given, that mod 2z minus 1 is equal to mod z plus 1, and you know the value of z is x plus iy. So this is given to us. Then the next step, what we'll do, we'll substitute the value for z. So I get x plus iy here, x plus iy. Now you should write this in this form, a plus ib, and you should write this also in form of a plus ib. That means real part together, imaginary part together. So here open the bracket, so you get 2x plus 2yi minus 1. So here we have got three terms, out of which only this is your imaginary part. So because I is there in multiplication, and here 2x minus 1. So 2x minus 1 will be written together. This is your a, okay, real part. And this is your b, imaginary part. Now on the right, you can see this is the term which involves I. So this is imaginary part. X plus 1, okay, will be your real part. This y is your imaginary part. So both the side now you have been able to express in a plus ib type. Yes, clear? Let me write c plus id type. Okay, now since we are taking modulus of this, so you know modulus of this will be given as this. Yes, square root of square of real part plus square of imaginary part. So in the next step, what we'll do, we will get this 2x minus 1 whole square plus 2y whole square is equal to x plus 1 whole square plus y square. Okay, so here you can see next step I have written over here. Now what we'll do is we will square both the side. Okay, we want to remove this root, so squaring both the sides we get this. Now simplify for this, expand this using a minus b whole square formula. So you get 4x square minus 4x plus 1, and this will be 4y square. Here use a plus b whole square formula to expand. So you get x square plus 2x plus 1 plus y square. Now take these all terms to the left hand side, okay? So this plus x square, this side it becomes minus x square, plus 2x, this side it becomes minus 2x, plus 1, this side it becomes minus 1, y square, this side it becomes minus y square. Now here 4x square minus x square, so you get 3x square. Here minus 4x minus 2x, simply minus 6x, plus 1 minus 1, 0, 4y square minus y square, 3y square, okay. Now next, what you absorb that? We have got three terms over here, okay, and each is multiple of 3. 3, 3 2 is a 6, 3 1 is a 3. So you can take out this 3 common, okay. Now 3 into this. Obviously, this is not 0, that means this has to be 0. So in the next step, we are writing this equal to 0. And we are taking this to the right. So we got this. This is what we were supposed to prove. Okay, so it's proved. This is your homework. Here it says if x plus iy is this, find the values of x and y. So here this question is same as your 5-2, I think. Yes, same as 5-2. So do this by yourself. Let us see next. So this is all for today. Okay, this is all for today. In the next class, we'll see some more questions. Okay.